Hello friends, welcome to our YouTube channel Invisible Science and its little studio, where I try to explain complex topics related to science in a very easy way with the help of 3D animation. Moving forward, in today's video, I will explain the full process of female sterilization reversal. Understanding female sterilization reversal in simple terms means an operation where the sterilization of a woman is reversed by reopening the fallopian tubes. Before understanding this reversal process, it's essential to comprehend female sterilization. Although the entire process of female sterilization has been covered in a previous video, you can find the link in the description or in the I button. Nevertheless, to discuss the basics, female sterilization is done in three ways. Tubectomy sterilization. A large incision is made in the abdomen to block the fallopian tubes. Laparoscopy sterilization. In this surgery, at least two small incisions are made in the abdomen and the fallopian tubes are blocked with the help of laparoscopy instruments. If we talk about hysteroscopy sterilization, in this process, without making any cuts in the body, the fallopian tubes are closed using plugs or coils through hysteroscopy. These three methods are effective and permanent procedure for prevent pregnancy or contraception. However, for some women, circumstances change and they want to restore their fertility, mainly due to the desire for childbirth. Now, the process of reversing sterilization or opening it begins, which starts with crucial consultations and examinations with a female and reproductive or gynecology specialist. Let's listen to their insights.
Sir, what could be the success rate of reversing sterilization?
Well, the success rate is based on various factors, such as the woman's age, the type of tubal ligation, and the length of the remaining fallopian tube. On average, the success rate ranges from 40 to 85%.
What kind of complication can occur during the procedure?
Like any surgical procedure, there are risks such as infection, bleeding, and damage to surrounding organs. Additionally, even after a successful procedure, there is no guarantee of conceiving a child. If tubal ligation reversal is not an option, considerations can be made for alternatives like IVF, in vitro fertilization. The entire process of IVF can be seen in this video. Now, let's understand the process of opening or reversing sterilization. This process is done through laparoscopy and hysteroscopy methods. Whether opened through laparoscope or hysteroscope, the goal is the same: to reconnect the fallopian tubes and restore natural flow. So, let's move to the operation theater and start the reversal surgery. Watch the video till the end and find the video informative. A like and comment are appreciated. So, let's first understand laparoscopy reversal. This surgery utilizes laparoscopy technique. First, insert laparoscopy instruments through small incisions in the abdomen. A light and camera are attached in laparoscopy, which displays the internal organs on the monitor. Then, with the help of microsurgical instrument, the fallopian tube is either joined or opened. Compared to traditional open surgery, laparoscopy surgery has a faster recovery time and reduced the risk. Now, let's talk about hysteroscopy sterilization reversal. This surgery is performed when the woman's sterilization was done using a hysteroscopy methods. In hysteroscopy reversal, firstly the uterus cavity is expanded and then through it, hysteroscopy is inserted into the uterus. The fallopian tubes are then carefully examined and any plugs or coils placed during the previous sterilization are removed. Since this procedure is less invasive compared to traditional open surgery and laparoscopy, the recovery is faster and risk is reduced, as we have now understand the entire process of tubal ligation reversal. If you found the video informative, please like, share and subscribe to our channel for more informative videos. See you in our next video.